So you open the door and you see a large indoor garden resembling a tropical paradise. There's like a open window which Aquafina would be like, yep, that's where that wind was coming through. Like, nailed it. There's lush plants and flowering vines hanging from the walls while a slow moving stream of water cuts through the center of the room, flowing from north to south. Planters filled with colorful flowers line the stream. Two narrow wooden bridges arc over the waterline passage from one side to the other. And there's a partially submerged life-size statue depicting an armored half-elf woman holding a rose and wielding a shield. And then it's just got like dense bush around over here and here.
Durek, is it safe? Is it
appears
safe,
so.
Durek?
He's gonna make a perception. Is anyone hidden that I can perceive? I do have dark vision, by the way.
Okay.
Someone had to say it. Because it is like, you said it was like around 3 a.m, so.
Yeah. I'm gonna roll something, but pretend your character wouldn't see this roll, okay?
Or just do the thing we did.
That's what I was trying to ask you before.
Oh, the turn. What? I don't remember.
That's right. You see, like sticking out from behind a bush, you see like two kind of like feet. You know the scene in Scary Movie when the killer's ghost face is like trying to hide behind the couch, and she can see.
He's like,
yeah, it's exactly like that, and they're just, you can see three pairs of feet all doing that, and they're all like.
Three pairs of feet.
Four pairs.
Three people. Where? I missed the ping.
Four, sorry. So you can see one over there. One over there.
Are you pinging? Because it. Yeah, you're probably
on the
gym layer.
That's right.
Yeah.
There.
Oh.
There.
Over the bridge.
There.
All right. There. So, like in the bushes there, you mean?
Yeah.
That's all right.
And I should be in the courtyard too.
Yeah, you can just enter this.
Yeah.
Long, yeah. Yeah, I'll. So let's see.
Call them out.
I'm not gonna say anything to anyone. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna. Before anyone does any other move, one action rage, and then I'm gonna move and just swipe into the person, the first one I see, like here.
Okay, cool. So that'll be your surprise, and then we'll start initiative.
All right. If I'm here, do I hit one, or do I need?
You
to
just killed
here?
An innocent, bro. You just killed a person who's hiding.
He's a barbarian, he doesn't care.
He don't give a fuck.
I'm not taking any chance. But yeah, Arcan, if I'm like at the end of the bridge, do I reach one or do I need to be off the bridge?
No, there you could reach him, that's fine.
Reach one? Okay. They are surprised. So I do believe I get to work at plus two. If they are.
You do, but it's not enough.
Oh,
hey, thank
so
you for
you
the follow.
Down and
appreciate you putties. Appreciate you. You
hit
I still
bridge,
don't know. This is my first ever campaign, so I don't know what's going on here. I'm doing my best. I'm doing my best. Thank you for the follow, though. I appreciate you.
From the bushes.
Ah. Oh.
And let's roll for initiative.
Rolling for initiative. Trying to find my character sheet. There it is.
These trash initiative rolls.
Sucks to suck.
I have so much good that I can do if I go first. but like I'm going lost.
Is that everyone?
You bet.
So you you share initiative with your little dude.
Eidolon.
Oh, okay, yeah, so we're both at 10. That was the first one.
Yeah, remember your Eidolon and you share your action with the act as one thing.
Yeah, okay.
Gonna murder some people.
Oh, did I not add Scratch?
Let me just in order. Alright, so this cutthroat here, he's gonna go. He's gonna stab you with his dagger.
My AC is 17.
Oh, that's not fair. Well, that'll be a miss then. And then he's gonna go for a second stab. 21.
Yeah, that'll hit.
Great, 5 points of damage as he just finds a soft spot in your armor. And then he whispers in your ear as he's close and he's like, soft spot.
Sexy.
And then he'll go for a third strike, because why not? And this is Aquafina.
Jesus. Can you stop rolling like a fucking madman?
I'm very good at this game.
So I need to move into this room.
Yep. I'm fine if you want to just start in the room, because you probably would have come out with everyone, correct?
No, it's okay. I can just...
Wow.
It's fine. So I move in after I hear some chaos happening, and then I should again be able to reach. So I want to cast my lightning onto these guys at the bottom.
Okay. And it's not one of your spells that you only have one per day, right? That's...
It's a cantrip.
Oh, yeah, cool. Gonna make sure you're not cheating this time.
Ah, baby Hunt, check my entire sheets.
Alright.
Yeah, I did.
So you're attacking this one?
Yeah, that guy.
And then you're wanting it to hit Durak as well? Or...
No, bounce to the one next to him.
Okay, so just double checking here.
No, it's okay, it's good.
Okay, they both fell.
Oh, yeah.
8 points of damage. Fuck, that's max, isn't it?
Yep.
All right, well, X, why don't you explain to the party what happens to them?
Oh,
damn.
Nice.
They must just, like, convulse and just, like, as they get shocked and then just, like, into ash. That seems dramatic. So, bye.
They just get shocked, and then their brain starts liquefying through their nose.
Okay, all right. But electric mummification.
And that'll end my turn.
Here we go.
Smash off. Look how beautiful it is. Look at that.
They're not ash. It was not a disintegration.
Right. We need their bodies to still be there.
And Durak, your turn.
All right. Well, I'll
what do it this time.
First attack that guy. It's gonna be real simple. So first attack, it's gonna be, bam, 24.
That is a hit.
And that's going to be 17 damage.
All right. What happens to our poor friend here?
Oh, it's like the ball of the flail just go like... while I'm missing him on the first one, come back around and just crush his ribcage.
Nice.
And he tries to whimper, but there's nothing for him to use.
Ribs, they're my favorite part of my body.
Yeah, and then we're gonna do another attack, and with sweep, I get a plus one. So that's gonna be 19. Is that a hit?
It does, unfortunately, yeah.
And that's gonna be 12 damage.
What happens to this guy then?
Oh, I use the full rebound to just, like, smash his leg. And then, while he's screaming in pain, just like... destroy his head.
Love. So this is, Insanity in X. This is what combat's like when I don't stat up the first encounters.
I mean, I've taken damage.
Exactly, but I mean, because, like, the first time we played, I statted, like, them up to, like, level 3, the monsters. I'm like, alright, let's give them a real tough time, and then...
Wow.
We nearly died, right? He had to give us an NPC to help us just to level it up.
Yeah, it was a bit mean. Nice, well done, guys. You, took down some more of these... I mean, you guys haven't really, I guess, done a perception on them, so you don't know really who they are.
But they're trying, look. I've seen them kill someone, and I'm not getting killed. Like I said, kill or be killed. I prefer to do the killing. Real
Can
quick.
Can I do a perception on them?
Sure.
Hold up a second. If anyone's going to do perception, it's going to be me. I'm going to do my final draconic rites, my guy. You're just a singer.
He didn't see anything anyway.
Bless the corpses. So
yeah. Oh,
did.
Crap.
Thanks.
I gotta go bless the corpses.
Go bless the piles of ashes as well, bro.
And the piles of ash, I wanna dig through them to find.
All right. Food. So I'll roll a perception as well.
Nope.
While they're doing that, I'll just real quick pat down their belt, see if these guys like have a elf potion also.
Oh, just wait for him to roll his perception.
Oh, thank goodness. Better than a 4.
So you are kind of looking at them and you notice on all of their right forearm, there's a tattoo that says live free or slaughter in Draconic.
In Draconic?
Huh.
Mm.
Oh! Oh! Dragon, your people, bro!
And each of their weapons displays a trail of 3 black tears tattooed under a left eye.
Each one of their what, sorry?
Weapons. There's like a little symbol of an eye with 3 black tears.
Zarek, do you know these people?
Foolish bard. I only know the words on their forearm.
Don't pretend your character knows what Draconic looks like.
Yeah.
No, but he understood it. He read it and he knew what was going on, bro.
I haven't told you guys yet. What are you talking about?
Wait, you can read?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think you can read. So...
But I will tell them what it is. I will tell them that companions, it does look like the tattoo. There's a tattoo on their forearms and it is the language of half of my people. In Draconic, it does read live free or slaughter.
Can I make a banditry lore? See if that rings a bell.
And also,
oh boy.
Jurek, you find on one of them as you said you were searching, you find a vial of lesser alchemist fire.
I don't need that shit. I need health.
Is that a nat 1 for Durak?
Absolutely not. Oh. Absolutely not.
You just think they're a bunch of hooligans, like, as if a bunch of hooligans could form a gang. You don't know.
Would politics tell me anything about that symbol? Is it like politics?
Yep. Mainly because of you're from this area.
Nice.
Agrafina, you notice there's a statue, and that's really cool. What a cool guy.
I mean, that it's important, the culture, all that stuff, you know, interior decoration. Gotta appreciate Lady Jumandi's efforts here.
Cacophonics.
Like pentatonics with caco.
You... You're pretty sure, but not 100% sure, but you kind of like, I'm pretty sure there is a gang called the Black Tears that have the symbol, but other than that, you can't really remember anything else about them.
Okay. So we know the Black Tear gang.
Can I look into that as well when he mentions it?
Yep.
I guess recall or something, anything like that?
Recall knowledge, yep.
Would that be politics as well?
Yeah, what law skills do you have? I think recall knowledge.
Where would I see that?
Let's quickly looking it up. That's why we have...
Recall knowledge is you use one of the skill that the GM tells you, and if you have lore that is pertinent to it. Like, right now it's probably either society skill.
Yeah, or lore. If you've got a lore.
I have a lore, yeah.
Which one do you have?
Politics, I'm guessing.
Yeah, that's fine then. Yep, you can roll that.
Yeah. How do we do this? There we go. Oh, no.
Oh my gosh. Wow. So we'll go off your 19 because you clicked the wrong thing of law.
I clicked. Yeah.
So you, when he says the Black Tears, you just clicks in your brain. You're like, oh my god, yes, of course. So you know they originally formed as a merger of 7 street gangs from New Stephen and Port Ice. They're a criminal organization of cutthroats and thieves, known to dabble in kidnapping, extortion, assassination, and sale of illicit substances. Members fanatically loyal and exceptionally ruthless.
And do I know any connection between them and dragons? Due to my ancestry history?
You feel like they just kind of write it because Draconic's like a cool language. That's right.
It's like cool. White people kind of like writing people Chinese characters. Like,
yeah, and they don't know what it means.
Like, it says love. Yeah.
Love that actually says small peepee.
Like tuna. Yeah. Okay, cool.
Kung Pao chicken.
All right.
I'll check the other body while they're doing that too. Like, I just need to find like one health
potion.
Yeah,
you guys don't find anything else on the bodies. It was just that one.
God damn it. I'll turn to Cacophonics because I guess he pocketed stuff. I'm just like, you take this vial of fire, and I'll need a health potion.
Sounds good to me, fair sir. Okay, so I'll give him one of my health potions.
Cool.
I'll take two.
Just chug it. Yeah, two. Damn it. Those fucking dice hates me.
And yeah, and then there's just the door that way heading towards the Great Hall. Anything
I'll kick
you
it down.
Here before you can... Okay. You kick it down. You see a long hallway with bloodied corpses of guards.
Yeah. Awesome.
Littering the hallway. Give me a perception roll.
Yeah.
You hear from this room a deep voice roaring and howling. Kind of just...
And is it fair to say we don't hear it from the outside?
No, you guys wouldn't, but...
Yeah.
I'm sure Derek might mention something. Maybe not. If he doesn't mention anything, then you can do a perception when you enter.
Are there other entrances and exits to this courtyard, or is it just the one?
Nah, just the one door.
Yep.
Well, if no one else will do perception checks, I'll move down towards the door.
I'll come in. I'll do that.
Detect magic, is that something you can only use during battle, right?
No,
you can use it anytime.
Is it worth doing a detect magic? Like coming into this room and doing a detect magic? I think so.
Well, I'm peeking into the hallway. I'm just in the doorway. I'll run a perception on the hallway. It, heck yeah, baby, let's go. At nat 20 life.
With that roll, you also hear growling from here. And you hear a loud gruff voice saying,
"Where are you, halfling? When I find you, I'll smash your eyes for good when I see you."
He's off to Lindsay. Get in there, Jarek. Get in there.
What language is he speaking? Common?
Yes, common.
Okay.
Jarek, go! Jarek.
I mean...
Get him!
Cacophonics, you didn't hear shit, so...
Yeah, I will mention... I will mention to the party... there's a beast looking for the halfling! And that'll probably be about it, because I don't know much more.
Alright, well, I'll kick down that door.
Bish.
Oh, that's a big boy.
So, did you say kick the door down or did you just open it?
Oh, kick down the door.
Okay.
So it probably hits his butt.
Yeah, give me an athletics roll.
Alright.
Oh no, fuck. It's this all over again.
God damn it.
Uh-oh.
So you kick the door down and it flies into the back of what you suddenly notice as a huge hulking ogre. And it just pings off him. And you he kind of turns to you and you can see like his eyes are like kind of like bleeding. Looks like they've been kind of like slashed at. And he growls at you and he's like,
"More fun, more to kill."
And he draws out a filthy looking ogre hook.
That's fun.
And he takes a step before you and we'll end it there.
No, oh, you no. Cunt. That doesn't prepare.
Just one more.
I believe that might be a bigger fight.
No, make sense.
Okay. What a all cliffhanger.
Alright, we can fight this one.
Yeah!
Alright.
Just one more.
Alright, we got this.
You're not hurt, Lindsay, ogre.
Is that her name?
Am I able to look through the door if it's smashed open from further outside?
Yeah, that's fine.
I mean, like I said, I'm pretty thick, so I probably take.
Well, I just need eyesight, because I want to go. I guess we're gonna roll for initiative, but I have something I want to try out.
But yeah, so Jarek, you do notice that this is a library, so it's a modest sized library in here. It's lying in ruins. Bookshelves have kind of been emptied, kicked over. There's kind of blood splattering around where the ogre's standing. It looks like he's been in a confrontation.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds about right. Important question. When you said he was huge, do you mean the size category or is he large?
Large, sorry.
Thank you. Because that will be useful. That means I can fuck him up. All right.
Let's roll for initiative.
Yes.
Initiative.
More initiative. Come on. Yes.
Oh.
Oh, get fucked.
Oh, I think I'm rolling two dice. One sec.
Aquafina, you're never in the room, are you?
Oh, finally.
Don't mind that other one. Don't mind the other one. 11. We'll take that.
And also remember, as well as moves as well, you guys can do like perceptions or recall knowledges as well to like lore rolls if to understand things about creatures as well.
Lol. That's not my job. I'm here to be hot and kill shit. That's what I do.
All right. Insanity at the top of the order.
Ah, so I know exactly what I'm doing because finally I'm in the right position.
And remember, if you want to pass through him, you need to do a tumble through.
I want to touch
Gross.
Baby hands inappropriately.
Gross. This is inappropriate.
I want to use this on Baby Hans's. What's your main weapon? The mace.
I am wearing a
the flail, yeah.
Alright, so you're pissing.
Is that a ducky merch?
Please tell me you're using a magic weapon.
So your flail.
Hell yeah.
It's one of my spell slots per day.
Hell yeah.
What becomes of this flail?
Now we're cooking.
Magic, magic, fill magic, the air. Magic, magic, make magic. This flail smash and tear. Magic,
oh, yeah.
Magic, kill them all. Direct, save my bay, Lindsay.
You remind me of Magic Man from Adventure Time.
Yes.
Magic Man is awesome, oh, dude. God. I love Magic Man. And then for my next action. So that just applies. I don't have to roll anything with that, right? Just applies. Yes.
Yeah.
Then my next action, I'm going to do a Inspire Courage. So everybody in a 60-foot area around me gets plus one.
That's that you consider an ally. Archon,
yes.
Not the ogre.
Okay, fine.
I saw it coming a mile away.
If Lindsay's in the area, she gets it as well, just saying. And then lingering composition just to see how long it lasts. And that's performance.
Okay.
21, so I guess that's a success, right?
That is success, yes.
So, basically for three rounds, you got plus one to attack rolls, damage rolls, and saves against fear effects.
Alright. Okay. That was a decent turn.
Oh, alright, Drax's turn.
Alright, so I'm gonna rage and then I'm gonna attack twice.
Archon, can you put the music down slightly?
Oh yeah, of course. Quite
high. So that first attack is gonna be a 14 and the second attack is gonna be a 17.
First one misses, second one hits. That seems like a lot of damage for your level.
It's that's good. Magical so weapon. That's going to be magic weapon does makes my weapon striking. So now it's 2d10. And I rolled a 10 on that one, a 10 and a 2.
Like
so it's still, it's still average. So that's
like
16 bludgeoning plus 1, so 17. And then a 4 psychic. So that's 21 damage in total.
Arkan's buffing up his monsters next time, right?
No, you won't.
Cool.
And that's my
turn. Yep. Ogre's still standing.
Obviously.
Okay.
Alright, is that your turn?
Yeah, it is. That was my three actions.
Did you also add the damage from my...
Yeah, yep.
The magic weapon
the
and Inspire Courage, hey?
Yep.
Cool.
It was 16 regular, 4 rage, 1 Inspire.
Okay, so for my... That's not going to be my Eidolon, that's me. I keep forgetting to switch it over.
Yeah, that's fine.
But I would like to attempt to cast Command... On it.
On the ogre.
And basically, I'm going to command it to pierce its heart with the with this ogre scythe.
I don't think it can do that with command. It just says what kind of command you can give them.
Yeah, so you can command the target to approach you, run away, release what it's holding, drop prone, stand in place.
Alright, I'll get it to drop its weapon then.
Sounds about right.
Alright, will saving throw. So what's your spell, DC?
17, I believe.
17? Fuck, that's quite high.
Spell DC is 17.
Nice.
Alright, he drops his ogre hook.
Can I go and grab it? For my other two actions? I actually only have one action.
Just no, kidding. Only because you can't end your turn on the space of an ally. And okay. You can't actually get through him, so you wouldn't be able to.
Oh. Unfortunate. Okay. I will stay where I am. Actually, you know what? I'm going to back up.
Just because you can't see in the room, I don't know if you can, but he's right in the doorway, so.
Okay, yeah. I'm going to back up here with my idol on. There we go. And now I'll end my turn there.
So your idol will have to stay there because you guys move separately, either move you or move him.
Well, he's on my shoulder.
Oh, so that was just more flavored while we're out of combat, but when we're
Okay. So he's here. And then Madeline will just chill there then.
Oh, cool. That way, if I kill him, then you die as well, you know? More fun.
Yeah. No, I love that.
So
I love that for you.
Yeah.
The ogre, unfortunately, he's wearing a, this big, like, fur coat, and Jurek, you notice in front of you that he's, like, when he kind of, after the command, he just starts to, like, vigorously scratch himself. So, let me...
That's not good. Whatever that is, it's not good.
Cool. So, it looks like he kind of scratched for a bit and then is still concentrating. He leans down, picks up his weapon. And then he will ogre hook our lovely friend Jurek.
Yeah, that's a hit.
That's 6 points of piercing.
That's alright.
And then
I'm halfway, if to tell people.
Cool, and then that's his turn. Awkwafina.
I need to move into the room. I should follow you guys, but I'm scared.
No, so look, that here is the like, basically this is an hallway. I'm in the door here, and he's in another room.
Yeah, okay. So whenever people enter new rooms, I always describe the room. So unless I'd be like initiative right away, like you should just follow usually in.
Okay, cool. So I'll
You'll be fine if you go here. You won't be near the ogre.
Okay, cool. So
yeah, we've got a big meat shield in front of us.
Yeah.
Jurek is on meat shield.
So I can't cast anything on him, though, if I can't see him.
You will have visibility. 10 feet.
Yeah, if you're like there.
10 feet, and if you go here, you'll be able to see it through the door.
Yeah, because of dynamic lighting, you can't exactly see him, but there's a big ogre right in front of Jurek.
Can we just measure? I should be able to just move there. Yeah, I'll be fine to just move there. Yeah. Cool. So, if I go there, where is the ogre?
Those four squares. A big ass fucker.
Okay. Cool. So.
Big ass ogre.
Yeah.
It's Shrek.
Let's freeze him. That could be fun.
Oh.
Rude. Guess that's a spell attack. That is a big old miss.
It's 16 though, hey?
Yeah, it is 16.
Oh yes, because I got fancy from Cacophonics.
She's also inspired.
Well, then that's a hit.
This damn is why they said that spell's so good. Everybody's like, that's one of the best spells like for Bard early game.
What a stupid game. I what happens to him?
Yes!
Seriously? I wanted to like freeze up. And be, like,
hell yeah.
Ice, like, and he's just like,
just good warm up fighting for you guys, you know?
Yeah.
Just you wait.
I mean, you got me good a couple times.
Oh, yeah.
Well done.
Like, that's just what happened when we're working, when we're making the right decisions during combat.
Exactly, yeah.
Dude, I wanted to just, like, I built this whole character to kind of use that magic weapon on you, bro. Like, sort of murder, bro.
I'll dig it.
So, yeah, you guys can enter the room. Lindsay comes out behind some bookshelves and is, thank you so much. Thank you.
Never fear, it was I that saved you.
Nope. In fact, she's gonna roll a perception.
I moved you,
that's fine, thank you.
X.
That's okay. Thank you.
No, I saw everything. I saw the lovely orc kill him, but I'm sure you did help as well. I did hear you singing outside.
Well, it was actually this sorcerer that killed him, the elf sorcerer, but it was mostly due to me. I mean, I'm the one who inspired the party.
Well, I can inspire courage too.
Ooh, why don't you inspire my courage?
Oh.
Go roll a diplomacy.
Oh no.
What have I done?
Foolish bard.
Oh, there you go.
She comes up to you and kind of like puts her finger on your chest, and she's like,
I think that sounds like a very good idea.
Yes! Can I try and influence her now?
Oh my
you
god.
You did. You literally just did.
There we go. Oh,
wait. Wait, can I intimidate her? Can I intimidate her, warning her about insanity? Or about Cacophonics?
If you want.
Yes.
But please, yes, insanity, that will increase sure. influence with her.
Yes.
Oh, wait.
While they're doing that shit, I'll just be grabbing the ogre's coat. Curious at what it is.
Yeah, ooh, sure. Shit. Are you putting it on or?
Won't put it on. I'll just
Before you grab it, let me just make sure.
I mean, we don't have this sure.
You don't detect any magic on it. You're just grabbing. You're not like.
I'm not putting it on you. I'm like grabbing it and then like checking like if there's any pockets or something inside.
Okay. Give me a as you pick it up, give me a flat d20 check.
Okay.
Actually no. Give me a
I'm gonna get flea.
Yes actually, yep. Give me that roll.
Just a d20? 19.
You don't get cast.
As you kind of pick it up, you straight away like notice, like it's infested with fleas.
Yeah.
And you're able to kind of just drop it before any kind of jump on you.
Ew.
Sorry, infested with lice.
Mmm.
Ew. No, that's bad. Fleas are better than lice.
So what was happening is with that creature, the way they nerfed the ogre is that at the start of its turn, it has to take an action to scratch. And if he fails, then he spends two additional actions scratching. But if he passes, then he has two more actions. But because he had to pick up his weapon and use another action, that's why he could only attack you once.
Yeah, I know.
Nice. I know. Was I able to intimidate...
Burn that coat.
What's her face?
No.
So you kind of... What do you say to her?
Oh, I just want to warn her. Women, be aware of this foolish bard and his foolish ways. He will only lead you to despair and suffering.
And she turns to you and she's like, if you knew anything about anything, you would know, as me as a bard, I know who Cocophonix is, and he is, from what I've heard, very well endowed. I mean, with his music, of course, and I hope the other stories are true. So, thank you for your advice, but as bard to bard, I think I can tell the right kind for myself.
And Aaron takes 10 points of emotional damage.
Emotional damage.
Emotional damage.
I can see now that all bards are foolish. I'll just walk away. Can I grab the hook, at least? Can I grab the hook?
Well, do you want to perceive to see what he has, maybe? What else does he have?
I just want the hook. I don't want that. I just want the hook.
Aren't you meant to be doing some rocks over his body? Do ogre lives not matter now?
Ogre lives don't matter. They don't have souls.
So you can... So the hook is... So, like, because the ogre is large.
Large.
The hook is, like, a large weapon. So... You wouldn't be proficient to be able to use it.
Fair.
But you can take it. It just will take up. I'll just get the weight for you.
It's doubled, so it would be 4 bulk.
4 bulk, yeah. Okay, so it'll be 4 bulk.
Okay.
Yeah, you can grab it.
I'll grab that then.
And then just put in your bulk, just ogre hook 4 bulk.
Jeez, like, that'll literally encumber me if I try and take that.
I got one left.
Excellent.
Can I do a perception on him to check if he's got anything else?
Sure.
Or to get any information about him either?
Well, you should have non-lethally attacked him and asked him.
Oh, but we're gonna say non-lethally kill him.
Yeah. yeah, you notice that he's got a list with every question you could have asked, and all the answers, just preparing just in case. So pretty much, like, the main thing was he had the big fur coat and the hook. Doesn't seem like he had much on him, but you do think it's kind of weird that there's an ogre here. Considering the black tears is usually made up of humans.
Wait, did we see any of the forearm tattoo or anything like that? Am I able to look for that?
Give me a perception.
Yeah. That is all my character wants to look for. Once he sees Draconic, things get a bit... Come on now. Oh my...
I mean, you don't want to get too close. It's pretty smelly.
Yeah.
And you don't see anything out of the ordinary either, Aquafina.
Unfortunate.
General perception, more on the room, making sure, like, nothing's out of order, like, except, like, it's trashed, but just want to make sure. Those perception check.
It just looks like it's been roughed up, and Lindsay tells you, like, she kind of you can talk to her. She says that she was
just going to do a check, a quick check of the room. And after checking the room, I'm just going to look at her and be like, are you able-bodied and able to help us fight?
So she says to you, like, when you're looking around, she's like, oh, I wouldn't bother looking around. I've already scoped it out. I was alerted by one of the guards that the Black Tears were assaulting us, so... we all got separated and this ogre cornered me in here, but yes, I can help. I can help.
Good. Now let's get out of this cell hole.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These bodies, Archer. Do we recognize any of these guys? Why does the white guy have a laser gun, bro? Why's he? Hey, lizard with a laser gun.
Because I thought he looked funny, so I thought I put some stuff in there to see if you guys would notice.
Wow.
Nice.
Before going down the hall, I'll just do a quick check. Like, said to the other, if you're expecting me to keep taking the hits for you, I will need a bit of help. A bit of medicine or something.
Sorry, roll out.
Have these bodies been
checked? General call too.
As a mighty warrior, you should always come prepared.
Wow. Good Jurek, because you are my
meat shield. Jurek makes a note.
I shall give you my last healing potion. So I give him the one healing potion.
I'll just chug it. Alright, please be a better roll. There you go. That'll do it. Plus eight.
Did we do any checks on the bodies in here? Has anyone done checks?
I didn't. I went fighting.
Yeah, you guys don't notice anything on them. They're just...
They're dead guards.
The one time I roll a good roll, there's nothing.
No, but right, what you do notice is you notice like this door here, which you remember with that roll. You remember that hit leads to the Great Hall. Then you just see some other
That's a door. That's a door, yep. And that's a door.
Yep, and you and expertise. Oh, sorry. Aquafina remembers that's the door that you guys came through to go to the Great Hall.
Which door should we try?
I'll turn to Lindsay and say, did you think the other hide in those room, or do you think they would have gone to the Great Hall?
I think they would have gone through to the Great Hall to help the mistress of the manor.
Alright. So we think we're fairly close to the Great Hall. Like, if I focus and try perception, I could maybe hear sounds of battles.
Yeah, we could do a perception.
19. And I'm focusing, like, towards that way. See if I hear any sound of fighting.
So you hear, like, heavy breathing.
Heavy breathing intensifies.
Oh-ho! You don't say.
Does it sound close to the door?
It sounds like in the room.
Just in the room in general? Door.
Yeah.
Do no one check these other rooms before we go in there? There may be other people in need of help?
Well, that's why I asked Lindsay if... I think it's more pressing to get to the Great Hall because their target might be the nobles and the lady.
Fair. I follow you, Drek.
Yeah, I'm expecting you to do it. Alright. So
I'm gonna stay behind, perform draconic final rites on these dead bodies, and then I'll follow you guys in after a few minutes.
And I will kick down the door.
Okay.
You mean you'll try to kick down the door?
I mean, I'm huge. And yeah, so just open it.
Alright.
Ooh. Well, that's another big boy.
So you find yourself in an oddly shaped scullery containing two sturdy tables for prepping food, a large tin wash station for cleaning dishes, doing laundry. You notice... What's it?
I mean, I think you know what I noticed first.
You notice a couple of corpses around the room. They just start to appear, because I forgot to add them in.
Yeah, right.
And you see, blocking the doors to the Great Hall, a frost giant who looks like he's been in a battle. He's got kind of arrows kind of sticking out at him. It was kind of leaning against the door. Looks like he's resting. And he's got like a big slash on his arm as well. he does notice you into the room, and he gurgles in a rage as he staggers to his feet, holding up bare knuckles, but he doesn't, like, approach you or anything. He just is kind of, like, in a defensive kind of...
I'll point my I'll just point my bloody flail and the head of the bandit that I got on my belt, and I'll be like, "Stand down and you might live.
This will not be a fight."
But how intimidating is it? Just like a drooping flail, pointing it. It's like a limp penis.
No, but he's holding the head, Ezo. He's like,
okay, well, fair enough.
That depends on the roll.
Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, 16, not bad. Like, he is very injured. Like, that's what I'm saying. It's like, this will not be a fight. This would be an execution.
Do you think that?
No.
Yeah. You know, we try. Like, if I can avoid fighting that cunt, I'll do it. He's a big dude. Like, the others don't see him.
You say this, and he's like, he lowers his fist a little bit, and he says,
I'm badly injured. You provide healing? Question mark?
Sure, if you promise, and I'll...
Common's a second language, so, you know, he didn't actually say question mark.
I'll do a perception to, like, sense motive, see if he wants to make me drop down my guard. 22? Is he lying to me?
I'll say that's a, you feel like he's not lying. He looks pretty, like, banged up. He's got, like, still all these arrows sticking into him and a huge gash, what looks like, from a sword on his arm. I mean, you all can see in his picture as well, there's a lot of blood.
Yeah, I'll get close, and I'll get close, and it's like dropping down the flare for a second, and just like, oh, for sure, I'll make sure your wounds don't bother you anymore. Does he let me get close?
Oh no.
Yeah, I'm just gonna ask, what's the rest of the party doing? Like, it seems weird that you just kicked down the door and they wouldn't follow, so what are the rest of you doing?
I'm busy doing the draconic rites.
Yep. And Aquafina?
I followed.
Phase for a wall, love it.
Whoa. You should have shown that trick to the other sister.
I know, right? I should have shown that guy. Oh well, next time.
So he asked you to make his wounds not hurt.
Yeah, and I'm getting into melee range, see if he attacks me.
Not healing range.
So you approach and he doesn't attack you.
Alright, I'll rage and I'll attack.
Oh my goodness.
So he's flat-footed?
Why attack the guy?
Before you do that, let's resolve that, yep.
Basically, I just wanted to drop his guard. He asked for healing, I get in reach, and I'll kill him.
So, in Pathfinder 2nd Edition, I don't mind doing it for our game, but they actually remove the surprise lowered AC thing.
Well, but it's just... I'm just asking if that makes him flat-footed, because he dropped down his guard.
Yeah, I'm saying that, just as, like, for our game. Yeah, like, absolutely.
Yeah, and that works in a against general, us,
just,
too.
Yeah, know? Just so everyone knows, in general, that's a new rule.
All right.
Yep. Roll your to hit.
Great. So that'll be two attacks, because I need one to rage. Oh, wait, I'm just going to drop the magic weapon buff, because it only lasts a minute, so it's done now. There you go. Oh, that's a crit on the first one. So the first attack is going to be 28 damage, and the second attack is a 16. How does it look, Archon?
All right, so 24. Fuck.
The first damage, it's 24 bludgeoning plus 4 psychic. And the second attack is a 16. I don't know if it hits. But he is flash put in.
Yeah. You ruined my cliffhanger. What happens to him? Fuck.
Oh, I bash his brains out and then I double tap. And what, like, just like, I'm gonna whisper it, so if people want to hear it, they like probably Cacophonics would hear it because he's right next to me. But and then I'm just like, just a sad whisper of like, I did promise to take care of your wounds.
What's your alignment?
My alignment?
Yeah, alignment, sorry.
Yeah, chaotic neutral.
Okay, yeah, that fits.
I was actually gonna refuse to fight him. Because my alignment's chaotic good. I was actually gonna refuse to fight him.
Nice.
I mean, that's something to think for, like, role-playing wise. Like, you guys would have seen, like, him be like, you know, not attacking, and then suddenly, while his guard's down, Durek just fucking murks him.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, like I said, good friend, you did hear me whisper that, like, almost sadly.
No, shut up. You and your bashing his brains in. You're so lucky I'm not in there. Yeah.
Yo, my character has depths, layers.
I'm just gonna put this on the chat here.
Can I heal him? Can I revive?
Revive? He's dead.
All right. Well, that with the murder of my poor innocent monster, that's a good place to end, I think.
So that's such a depressing end. Yeah.
Bro, I would save that guy. I'm sad for him now.
I was even gonna say, like, save him.
I was legit. I don't have a potion. I was legit gonna use soothe on him. I was like, fuck, I can only cast one more spell today. It's the right guy to use soothe on, bro. But they're all scared he turns around and fucks me up after I soothe him, right?
Amazing, though.
Kill or be killed.
That was fun. How did everyone enjoy that and chat as well?
I liked it. Ugh. That was good. I'm sad. I'm sad.
I feel sad now.
Hey.
Once my character finds out about this, we are not going to be friends.
That's all right.
All right.
You don't know me.
I don't.
You don't know me.
I don't want to now. Jeez.
Nah, I love it.
All right. That's good. That, what a crit. What a time to crit.
Right?
No.
Like, I think that was like the first proper crit we got this whole game.
Yeah.
Yeah, deep.
Against a defenseless poor frost.
Yeah, guy. Literally. Poor guy.
That's what we call a good role play crit. The dice wanted to tell a story.
Exactly. And as he fell to the, I forgot to mention, as he fell to the ground, a note flew and floated towards Awkwafina. And there was a drawing of him with all of his pet dogs and saying, I'll come back to you soon, my pets. And you'll be excited to know I'm going to be proposing to Cecilia. And
oh,
she'll
no.
be here to. Look, after I'm just doing this quick little job to earn some extra money for the ring.
So, baby hands, how soon do you want your list of characters, bro? The rest of the body turns on him, bro.
I know, Frost Ryan. They're not nice. Don't try to guilt me over this shit.
Yeah, it's fine. The dogs will be okay. It'll be okay. It'll be all good.
They're Frost Ryan dogs. They probably eat babies.
Hey, actually, gotta get your meat somewhere. What are you talking about?
Actually, yeah, that's fair.
Awkwafina is, I bet, is enjoying this, to be honest.
Look, I
no
probably
spoilers.
Would have felt the same way as Baby Hans, but kind of felt bad for the guy as well. So,
okay.
I don't know.
You do not know what my character is feeling. You have
you
no
killed
idea.
The guy, so.
Yeah. I'm not saying you felt good about it.
You don't have to bash a guy's brains out, though. That's, I don't feel this hurts me more than it hurts you as you like destroy this man.
Archon got my backstory, so he might have some inclination why I'm doing that kind of things.
You know what? Generational trauma means nothing in terms of excruciating violence.
Yeah, this is great though. This is like perfect. Yeah, like good role playing for like the other players don't know, you know, the backstory stuff. So like it's good opportunity.
Yeah,
you know, like for everyone to slowly learn it and be like, all right, what the fuck's happening here?
We'll see about that. We'll see how my character feels.
Oh, so that's exciting. So yeah, you guys managed to survive the Black Tears part one of their assault.
No.
It was lucky.
I mean, like
Awkwafina heard the guard out the front get stabbed, otherwise they might have come in, they were probably gonna come into your room next.
Yeah.
Ooh, they would have killed us.
Nah, they would have at
or
least
tried
come
to
in.
Anyway.
Yeah, they would have.
They weren't the strongest, but yeah, they would have might have got some damage off.
Well,
we're
especially
gonna find that kid that tried to poison us. Gonna find him.
That's a traitor. That's a snitch for sure.
That is a snitch.
I gotta go make sure. I need to make sure that my girl Jay Ethel is all right.
I got my girl, so I'm happy.
Yeah, I know. What the heck?
I don't need joiners no more.
Nah, I'm gonna be going on so many fake dates with the PCs.
Wow.
Oof. But yeah, no, that's a good start.
That was a great start.
The NPC sounds very interesting. Like they're fun. Like the snob gnome, the drunkard barbarian, the handsome dumbass. That sounds like
we didn't
like,
even talk to all of them.
Yeah, no,
we didn't talk to a few of them.
We might get to chat to some of them, but that's the whole thing. Like you can
choose,
try increase influence because some of them won't. Like, if you ask them, they won't. Like, if it wasn't for Insanity having good already influence with
Lindsay,
then she wouldn't have come with you. She'd have been like, no thanks.
Mmm, nice.
Good.
Hell yeah. My girl.
Yeah, that was a good crit for her to influence.
That was good.
Yeah,
was
pretty... I'm not here for the talking, making friends and stuff. I'm here to kill.
My guy's charisma based. He's all about the
You're
talking.
All charisma based. You're all gassed.
Yeah.
But to be fair, my charisma's not bad. Like for a barbarian, I think +2 charisma is actually pretty damn good.
That's not bad.
Like
I've got
like
zero strength.
Yeah. That's all right. You live. Maybe if I choose to.
I'm literally just sitting behind you, bro. Like literally the whole time I'm sitting behind you. Meat shield.
Yeah, I feel that's gonna be a recurring thing.
Just a recurring theme.
I'm just worried for the bosses that come behind us and shit like that. I'm like, oh fuck.
Get behind the fig boy.
Amazing.
But yeah, Aaron, that was your first time, basically. It's a small taste.
First time.
How did you find it?
It was really good, yeah. Now, it was my first ever campaign and my first part of the first campaign, so I found it was really cool. I enjoyed the role-playing aspect. And
being... It helps when you got an amazing DM as well.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah, we need to
the
find
voices...
one of those for your next session.
Yeah,
the voices. Looking forward to the next one. And for everyone watching, next one should be next week if everything goes to plan.
Next week's Sunday, right?
Next week's Sunday.
Back to Sunday, right?
Yeah.
And I probably don't work for some reason, so.
Even though we set a precedent for Saturday, it is switching to Sunday.
Yeah, that's just because I'm going to a concert tomorrow, so.
Yeah. Some of us have lives.
Nah, it's not canceled. This one got moved to Victor Arena.
Ooh.
Bitches in their real life.
Which concert are you going to?
Flatboy Sim.
Oh,
so,
if any viewers want to come and get my autograph, I'll
You're gonna wear that t-shirt.
Yep. I sleep in the shit all the time.
Taking back Sunday emo campaign. Yeah, Ferret. That's what we're good. That's what we're doing. I mean, it's literally
I love
like
Back Sunday. They're like one of my favorite bands ever.
Like, I just love the fact that all your characters are like Insanity. I hate Cacophonics. I hate him. He's amazing. Like, I hate him. It's incredible. Good job. Good job. Like, and like, there's the half dragon, self righteous dude, and then just the mysterious sorcerer. Then there's just me, big broody dude. Just like, I'm gonna be such the straight man in this chaos.
Yep.
Yeah, it's a good mix.
So I will have it up next time, is where people can vote for who they want, if they're with their team DM, team Zarek, or team or Aquafina. So I will have that up next time, so people can vote.
Yeah, you better.
And then we can see who people like. So I'll also put it up in the Discord as well, that next session people must come and like choose their team.
Yeah.
And see who they get. But like, the whole point of my character is not to be liked, bro. So
Team D's.
I like him.
You like to kill him.
Well,
no, I like him because he's making the party not like you. So you don't like
him. Already, my character already doesn't like Durek or Daruk and the foolish bard, but not, you know, kind of like neutral to dislike with Daruk because I don't know what's going on with him. He's just annoying, but the foolish bard.
Here's where I make it like a bit interesting, because although I want them to not really like my character, I want him to prove quite useful. So like that inspire courage. So I've taken all the spells to kind of like really help the party out. So I want it to be like this, fuck, I want to kill this guy, but man, he actually helps in a fight, right? So I'm trying to go with all these things that kind of like help the party, like his reactions and things like that to help. So it's kind of like, man, I want to kill this guy, but he does help.
Yeah.
I'm going to need to go to bed because I'm getting up at 5.
Wow. Oh.
Yeah. I got...
It's self-inflicted. I'm going to go for a run.
That's crazy.
Oh, whoa, a run? Look at you go.
That's insane.
Attaboy.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, got him.
My staircase has been destroyed, but we're going to go run at a new place.
I'm going to try and find somebody to raid into. Let's see if anybody's playing D&D.
Wait. Let me raid into you real quick, and you can raid into someone else.
There you go.
Why don't you both raid the same person, and then they'll feel super...
Yeah, you might as well raid the same person.
I need to go to bed. I'm not going to bother.
I probably can catch, like, at least another hour of sleep before going to work.
Yeah.
Everybody, make sure to follow me. Make sure to follow Insanity. Make sure to follow Archon. Make sure to follow X, the genius.
Yes.
And until next time, we'll see you later.
All right.
Okay, I'm going to go to these people.
All right, let's see that raid. I want to see who that is. Medic raid. Who the fuck is that? Ude. All
right. Guys, take it easy. Have a good one.
Thank you for the raid, Medic. I will pass on those viewers. Thank you, DM Archon. You're absolutely amazing. Let's go check out these guys on how their campaign's going. I'll catch you guys same time next Sunday. Episode 2.